Good morning to everybody. First of all, I like to thank Sitara management to they have given a great opportunity to me to present this TAPS model to everybody pan India, and I am happy to announce that it is likely to be rolled out very shortly, probably by end of August. We are planning before that, so let us try to understand the concept. Let us try to understand the benefits what we are going to get out of stamps and how the functionality is designed and other related issues. So with your kind permission, I like to start my presentation. I think I am audible and my screen is visible.
Yes sir, audible.
Okay, thank you sir. So I am going to give an overview of TAMS, because TAMS is a very big module and there are lot many features. Now I am going to give how the existing system is working in the railways and how it is being taken in the system, a centralized standardized software development and application development. Before that, first we should try to understand how the revenue is accounted in general. Probably all the traffic accounts people will be aware of this process. But anyway, I'll just take 2 minutes to explain this. The earnings starts from station and ends with account current. This entire process takes 2-3 channels. One is traffic accounts receipt, returns and balance sheet and the internal check section. Then it will be passed to traffic book part ABCD. Then finally account current. That is one channel. Another channel is station submits CR notes and vouchers. It will be passed through vouchers register. Then it will reflect in accounts office balance sheet. Then traffic book. Then account current. That is another channel. Third channel is day-to-day CR note submission to cash office. Then data entry in IPAS. Then it will reflect in the cash register. Then it will go to traffic book part ABCD. Then finally account current. So all these three channels are to be streamlined and consolidated in one particular place called TAMS. That is what we are going to focus. So our objective is to start with the station balance sheet to end with the account current. So our journey, how we perform our journey from station to account current, I am going to brief you.
Sir, PPT is
presentation mode. Okay, sir. This is okay, sir?
Yeah, fine.
Now, why computerization of traffic accounts is required? See, basically, all the information is generated through POIS, UTS, PRS, that is purely a data. It will never give any final processed information, which generally does by traffic accounts. So, traffic accounts earlier was working in a completely manual mode. Subsequently, AFRIS was introduced. AFRIS was also taken care in a piecemeal manner, which was not integrated with the FOIS and UTS. So Minister of Railways thought that there should be an integrated package where entire thing is seamlessly moved and instantly data is available and information is available to everybody. So considering that aspect, TAMS was sanctioned in 2016-17 and a MOU was signed with the Northern Railway, being the nodal railway for project management, and Western Railway was made nodal railway for development of the module with along with the quiz. And functional development was coordinated by Western Railway until last year. Then subsequently it was handed over to Central Railway. And mapping entire computerization process was taken care by Western Railway, taking the standard principles of accounts, which was mentioned in traffic codes and other manuals. But still, there are certain flexibility to be incorporated in the computerization. So all the without breaking any rule or implementing any rule, the gaps were filled. Thereby manual intervention is eliminated. Then finally, TAMS took a shape for further development. So what is the basic idea and implementation of TAMS is? We are, first of all, basic concept is, we are not going to invent anything. The features are already available. We are consolidating everything. We are taking the data from different sources and finally making a clear, usable information. And one more thing what we have done, just now I mentioned it, all the modifications in the data shall be routed through error sheet module only for accountable addressability. This is a new feature which we have introduced. Everybody is aware that there is an error sheet. When there is a loss in the railways detected through internal check, error sheet will be raised. System will account for in the balance sheet. Then they will give the reply to accounts office for the recovery or for allowing the credit. So this process entire thing we have put it in the TAMS in a innovative way. Whenever there is a difference in the figures comes to accounts office TAMS files from files to TAMS. If there is a difference, then an error sheet is raised automatically, which will be accounted in the balance sheet. So any correction is to be carried out. That should be through error sheet only. Either earlier it was not like that. There was many of you may be aware that when there is an error in the balance sheet, a corrected balance sheet has to be submitted. So corrected balance sheet, revised balance sheet will be submitted. Then that will be taken care of to account. And if the balance sheet is not submitted, then approximate balance sheet is to be prepared. So these are all various rules. Now through computerization, we are not following that. We are following balance sheet is coming, but if any error is committed by station staff to take the item to the balance sheet, then that will be corrected to error sheet. And error sheet has to be accounted in the same month balance sheet anyway. That I will come to the next step. So this is a new innovative methodology without violating any rule we have incorporated. Now, all the entries appear in the balance sheet will come only after thorough reconciliation in the first stage itself. What is the meaning of reconciliation in the balance sheet? I will say, now majority of the payments in goods are through e-payment. So e-payment, once the payment is paid, RR is generated. Whether the amount is correctly remitted in the collected in the bank and it is remitted in the RBI, we are not aware, sitting at the traffic accounts office. And station is also not aware. So we have incorporated new feature whereby balance sheet will be generated as CR note will be prepared only after reconciliation of the figure with the bank. So bank should say yes, this amount is received. Then only CR note will be generated. So we are not violated any rule, but there is a reconciliation. So we are completely aware that money is received in the bank and received in the railway account. Now, balance sheet is the final outcome of station transaction. Everybody is aware. So that is the final statement of the station transaction. Every transaction has to reflect in the balance sheet. Probably many of the TAs may be knowing, shunting bills and siding bills are raised first, then that will be taken into account in the balance sheet. Of course, it is not a mandatory thing, or it is a practice in many railways. So in such situation, though certain earnings are accrued, it will not be reflected in the balance sheet unless it is realized. Anyway, that is a commercial prerogative. They take some question whether that will be admitted or recovered or not. So they want to take that question. But we are forcing every transaction to come into the system through balance sheet. Then the accrual principle is applied here and realization will be monitored. So ultimately, TAMS become a data warehouse of voice, PMS, UTS, PRS and all sort of revenue data, truly processed and it is available to everywhere, anytime and everybody. So what we have done in TAMS in the innovative way, now TAMS will minimize the manual intervention because system takes care of everything. Data is flow from one application to another application seamlessly. There is no manual inputs. Of course, initially it is there. Gradually it will come down to zero. Internal check is completely eliminated, we can say. And online system smart checks are introduced. Smart checks means it is a reconciliation. Earlier people used to reconcile in the traffic accounts and book section, whether RBI has received the money or not, whether daily DMS is tallied with the cash remittances or not. All these manual things are there, which is eliminated now. System takes care of rest of the thing. Now, FOIS, UTS, PRS slightly tweaked to suit the requirement and seamless data flow. How we have done is, that is just now I told you, it is through error sheet module. Everything, damage, warfare, siding, shunting or any other transactions, if there is anything to be modified, it will be through error sheet module. I'll show the screen how it is done. So this is one other innovative technique we have applied. Now, reduction in overall abrasions modification in the revenue data. So ultimately, every correction, every modification is to be done through error sheet. So we have more focused on error sheet module. Reconciliation mandatorily it is become a part of the accounting data and data flow. Without reconciliation, data will not flow from one stage to another stage. MIS application, of course, it is a very much essential because all the apportionment earnings, all the originating earnings are to be consolidated to one place, and that is required by GM, even Railway Board, commercial department, everywhere. So that become easy. So another thing is almost all transactions to be part of station balance sheet. So we have taken a clear decision that everything has to be routed through balance sheet, though it is originated at somewhere else, like UPI payments or UTS app payments or online WR wagon registration transactions or any other online bookings. All these have to appear in the place where the service is rendered. That is our concept. Where service is rendered, that particular station has to own the responsibility that they accounted for. So we are incorporating that concept in the system. TIA inspections. So a elaborated TIA inspection module is developed, which gives the complete paperless reporting system. And further, we are so far it is not there, but we are coming to a new module for traffic finance and costing, which will once it is TAMS is developed, then we will go to that extent. So ultimate target is final JB and account current. Now. So commercial department may question us, what is the benefit of TAMS module to us when we are integrating, we are doing all this online working and palana palana. Then we explained them, even we had several meetings with commercial people also, we explained them. Apportionment data is directly available to them through them to TAMS. Because so far what apportionment is being done by traffic accounts, TRP section, and that is being communicated to Railway Board and commercial department. So they need not wait for that. Now if you press the button of the this thing in the TAMS, they will get the complete report at any point of time, they can use it. They need not depend on the accounts department. Now, dispensing submission of manual system of balance sheet. Now, board has also clearly issued instructions to stop the manual balance sheet. Only system balance sheet has to be submitted. Station outstanding data is directly available to all the divisors and headquarters. So far, station outstanding, commercial is compiling something, division is compiling something, and headquarter commercial and traffic accounts are compiling something. Because at one place, that is only traffic accounts office, you will get all the information, what exactly is the outstanding available at that particular month of period. Now, through this module, the data is available to everybody directly at any point of time. Division-wise earnings is also made available through traffic book part A, because earlier average was not to be given to divisions. Now traffic book part A is directly available to DRM and senior DCM, so that they can clearly see that what is the outstanding, what is the division-wise earnings of different category. Availability of zone-wise inward and outward data, that is also clearly available, because we have incorporated traffic book, apportionment data. Apportionment data in the system. So the moment apportionment data incorporated and is available to everybody, so everybody will come to know what is their inward, what is their outward data pertaining to the particular zone. Instant accounts allow debit. This is important aspect. In the manual system, of course, debits rising or error sheet issue is the completely manual process. So by incorporating that new error sheet module, all the debits will be accounted for instantly. Before finalizing the next balance sheet, that we made it mandatory. Because ultimately they have to say whether the debit is correct or not. If it is not correct, they have to say it is not admitted because of the reasons. Then only next balance sheet will be generated. So they cannot sit on the debits and unaccounted for a longer period. That is just not possible now. So this will avoid a lot of correspondence also further, because system will provide to give the remarks why it is admitted or it is not admitted, why it can be withdrawn. The correspondence can be through system only now. There is no paper correspondence. Finally, we are planning, of course, we have already gone through half of this thing. Manual CR and PR notes are going to be stopped very shortly. So system will generate as system generated CR note and TR node, so that on-rail reconciliation become easy. And of course, now we are going to cash up any in railways. Cash up is not in fully functional, so we are going to stop that activity also by taking through all the reconciliation data entry, data transfer through TAMS. So ultimately, what we want to achieve out of this TAMS? Integration of all accounting returns of different verticals of railway, passenger, goods, other coaching service at one place. So you will get all the accounting information, that is revenue related information, in TAMS at one place. That is our objective. And collect earnings to reconcile with cash book. That has to be done. Probably many of may be aware or not, I don't know. There is a concept called collected earnings, originating earnings and apportioned earnings. So at every month, collected earnings are bifurcated into originating earnings, then finally it will be transferred to apportioned earnings. So that concept we have incorporated in the TAMS, whereby this system takes care of bifurcation of collected earnings and originating and finally apportioned earnings. So collected earnings will be reconciled with cash book, that is a separate activity. Originating earnings are taken for a statistical purpose, that is separate activity. Apportioned earnings based on the 7C and the 6C over passenger, that is taken care separately. All these three separate activities are channelized into single activity. Finally, a apportioned zonal railway level apportioned matrix is generated. Now, computerized balance sheet is integrated with the traffic accounts office, traffic book part A, B, C, D. This is to be generated, and balance sheet with cash module, that is available in the IPAS. Finally, account current. So this is our journey. Finally, what we are going to start from the beginning of the balance sheet, end of the account current. So these are various modules available in other sources and TAMS. TAMS, there is one apportionment module, goods balance sheet, coaching balance sheet, traffic book and account current. These, of course, there are sub modules are there, but these are all the major modules for finalization of the traffic accounts module. So apportionment, of course, to generate the information from for this different modules, the inputs come from RBS, PRS, UTS, FOIS, PMS and IPAS. RBS gives the apportionment data, apportionment distances. PRS gives the originating passenger, PRS and UTS. FOIS gives the freight data, PMS parcels, and IPAS cash information. So all this second, third, fourth and fifth, these four components compensates and balances with IPAS cash. Then only a balance sheet can be finalized. So all these four components, information generated from this component will be transferred to different modules and data is processed. Finally, outcome will be released as a clear required information which can be used by anybody. So let us go minute details of integration. Sharing of monthly passenger earnings data in consolidated format, coaching earnings apportionment. We have coaching earnings. Out of that, military, paramilitary traffic also is included. That is to be segregated and account service balance sheet is prepared. This is one aspect. Similarly, UTS also. Monthly data, coaching as a whole, and this military, paramilitary traffic separately. FOIS, all goods freight data, balance sheet and internal check, apportionment matrix based on the RBS information and finally compilation of traffic part C, sharing of military and paramilitary data with for compilation of account service balance sheet, sharing of data of cash and pay module in the balance sheet for internal check module. These are all various, the same is explained here basically. This is the integration of various modules into one single TAMS module and the same various bifurcated into different sub-components. So what are the major modules available in TAMS? Let's come to that. Apportionment module. Apportionment is done for goods and passengers separately. Both are already working in the TAMS. All the railways are using it. Balance sheet module, goods of course, goods and coaching balance sheet. Balance sheet modules, goods balance sheet is available in FOIS, coaching balance sheet is available in UTS. So to generate coaching balance sheet, PRS data is to be transferred to UTS then and PMS of course. PFS, PRS data is to be transferred to UTS, then coaching balance sheet will be finalized. I just want to add two more comments at this point of time. Now, one single balance sheet will only be prepared for coaching balance sheet. There will not be a separate balance sheet for PRS, there will not be a separate balance sheet for UTS, PA, parcels, YTSK, JTPS and other PRS centers. All the centers, all the locations are to be consolidated to one single balance sheet, and one single balance sheet for coaching, one single balance sheet for goods will only be generated. Please note this. To this extent, board has already issued guidelines and instructions to develop in that way. There will be one CR note for cash, one CR note for vouchers. That is also, we have appraised board, so instructions are yet to come. And the third major point is error sheet module. Initially, the error sheet module was included in TAMS itself. Then we thought that error sheet ultimately has to be taken care of debits raised by accounts and it should account for in the FOIS and UTS balance sheet. So we have shifted this module and by slightly modifying the FOIS balance sheet. So as on date, error sheet module is directly not available in TAMS. It is available in FOIS and UTS. Traffic book module part A, B finally developed, used, implemented. Automated JV is also generated. Traffic book part C and DR under progress. We are waiting for accounts office balance sheet module is to be finalized. Once that is finalized, then we can compile part C. And then finally, part D. Part D is nothing but the final JV, revenue JV. So once traffic book part A, B, C, D are finalized, account current become easy. So account current is nothing but a final preparation of final JV to incorporate in the general books of accounts. And ultimately, a revenue schedule has to be generated. That is our target. In addition to the above, TIA module is introduced. TIA module consists of district management and TIA management. Finally, the reporting system. Reporting system will be completely online. There will not be any paper submission of the report. There is a option for internal check of the reports as well. I'll come to that later. Next, what we are planning is EFT internal check module, which is completely in a manual mode now, and sundry revenue module. Sundry revenue, basically sundry earnings come from, majority come from divisions and partly come from stations. So there is no system to capture this data directly and to transfer that into traffic accounts. So being part of traffic accounts, we want to develop this in the TAMS. So we are working on this one. So apportionment module, balance sheet module, traffic book module, part A are completed and launched. Of course, balance sheet is not fully automated. It may take maximum one more month. And ECR module, that is CR node, online generation of CR node, comprehensive error sheet module, TIA module, AOB module, traffic book part C and D. It is almost all finished. Very shortly it will be rolled out. Credit side reconciliation, EFT internal check sundry module. This credit side reconciliation, as I told you in the beginning itself, everything has to be reconciled before finalizing the balance sheet. So we are working on it. It is also almost all done. Very shortly this will be rolled out. Internal check EFT and sundry module is in the very preliminary stage. So now, how this error sheet mechanism functions. Goods balance sheet comes from FOIS, it will be transferred to TAMS balance sheet. Coaching balance sheet also comes from UTS and to be transferred to TAMS balance sheet. Cash information comes from IPAS, which is transferred to balance sheet. So balance sheet, TAMS balance sheet reconciles these three data. Coaching, FOIS, UTS, FOIS and IPAS data. Once there is an error, it will be transferred to the same source, that is either FOIS balance sheet or UTS balance sheet, through error sheet module. So error sheet module becomes a link for correcting the TAMS balance sheet as well as FOIS and UTS balance sheet. Many of you are aware, of course, it is a basic thing in traffic accounts, that there was a concept called advice of internal check. So when balance sheet is submitted to traffic accounts office, when there is a difference in the figures, balance sheet figure and profit figures, audited figures, advice of internal set will be communicated to stations, giving the particulars of the breakup and difference. So the same concept we have introduced to error sheet, thereby TAM's balance sheet and goods balance sheet will be in sync through error sheet. The moment there is a difference, error sheet has to be raised, error sheet will be accounted with the goods balance sheet. So goods balance sheet and TAM's balance sheet totals will tally. Similarly, UTS. Now, once a balance sheet, these two are in sync, then the entire process starts towards traffic book module. So traffic book module is nothing but the final account of earnings, and finally it will lead to different reports as well as account current. So this way we have introduced this error sheet module, how that becomes a link between different applications outside TAMS and with the TAMS, and how it rectifies the error and gives the true picture of revenue and for the finalization of the revenue schedule. Now, how this error sheet module functions? See, this is nothing but the existing practice. We have not modified, we have not changed anything. But how the system takes care of? Balance sheet, internal check will have, I'm talking about this is only goods. Balance sheet, internal check will take care of CR notes not received, damage warfare, errors in damage warfare, shedding, sending, and RR check and others. So if there is any error found in these four components, then error sheet module will be open up, then error sheet will be issued. Of course, error sheet, we have introduced three levels of approval, AA, SO and AFA. Depends on the local circumstances, flexibility is also given to all other railways to develop their own methodology. Once error sheet is issued with the approval of AFA, then it will go to the goods balance sheet. If it is not agreed and he has to give the remark, it will come to traffic accounts office. Traffic accounts office will verify the remarks once again. Still it is not convinced, it will go to goods balance sheet once again. So this mechanism continues till the remarks are convinced. Till the time that will be shown as NAD. Finally, once it is agreed by station, then it will go to recovery. If it is agreed by traffic accounts office that error sheet is not correctly due, then credit note will be issued. So this is the standard existing mechanism only, but we have incorporated in this entire module in an effective way so that all our internal check takes care of the differences through error sheet only. Now we have debit, this portion is called debit resolution mechanism. This debit resolution mechanism, Central Railway has developed one protocol that within a stipulated time, as mentioned in commercial manual, the 15 days period, one has to give the reply. Without reply, it will be automatically, it has to be accounted for in the balance sheet. So the same concept is utilized. So within 15 days, they have to give the remark, and traffic accounts has to give their views. If it is agreed, it will be great that this will be issued. Periodically, this mechanism, input mechanism will take care of the outstanding debits and whether to elevate to next higher level for a necessary action or to settle the issues with the credit advice note. Now, let us come to the TIA module. This TIA module, traffic accounts office, of course, the TIA comes for centralized system. It comes under traffic accounts office only. There is no question of division wise TIAs separately. I don't think any railway has that system. This now TIA module has TIA management, district management, forecast and movement, TIA district station mapping. These are the basic modules whereby management focuses on the inspection process. TIA manager, who is the TIA, what is his profile, and where he is working for the last so many years, and where he is working today. District management means how many districts are there in the zone, and what is the stations attached to the district, and who is the TIA attached to the district. Once the district management TIAs are finalized, then TIA's forecast and movement starts. Forecast means, as per the manual of TIA, he has to give a 10 days forecast of the inspection process. So next 10 days, where he will be and what he is going to do. At the same time, he has to give the movements on daily basis. Besides is the forecast. So we have incorporated this concept in DIA module, where he has to give the forecast, and we have given the flexibility to modify the forecast through movement. For example, I am forecasting after 4 days, let us say today is 27th, I am forecasting 30th, I will be at Secunderabad. So suddenly my boss instructed me that no, you cannot go to Secunderabad, you go to Warangal. So while mentioning the movement, I will say, I will show my movement for Warangal, and I will give the reason why I am going to Warangal instead of Secunderabad. So that data, that information is captured. Finally, DIA district and station, this is the complete mapping, will give you a true picture of DIA activities. So sitting at headquarters, traffic headquarters office inspection section, senior AFA or AFA station inspection, will come to know where DIA is working on that day, where what is his forecast, how many inspections have been completed, what are the inspections are on hand, everything is available through this. So they need not wait till the monthly reports are received, they need not wait till inspection reports are received. And instantly it can be done. It is available to all the inspection team. This DIA. So then DIA will carry the inspection process. DIA will carry inspection process by verifying the FOIS and UTS, all the prescribed checks as per the DIA manual. Once they carry out, they submit the reports. They submit the inspection reports to traffic accounts office. Inspection reports submitted to traffic accounts office will be verified with reference to district, forecast, movement, and other activities. This is called internal checkup for inspection process. Of course, it is there everywhere in all the traffic inspection sections. So, since inspection checks carried out by TAA will be on FOIS and UTS PRS, we cannot take that information into TAMS. Only the link connecting point is TR6F. TR6F is the irregularities noticed and reported by TIA. So that TR6F will become part of the TIA module, and he has to submit the remarks, and he has to upload the commercial remarks in the TIA module. So another major activity in TIA, TAMS module is accounts office balance sheet. So accounts office balance sheet is nothing but the consolidation of all the vouchers received in lieu of cash, and raising the bill against the concerned party and monitoring the realization. That is the basic concept. So what we are doing is, we are taking the voucher data from UTS and PRS, and it will directly come to the TAMS. Same vouchers data, which are voucher, physical vouchers, which are submitted to IPAS and entered in the IPAS, that will be also taken in the TAMS. Both are reconciled. Once both are reconciled, we will come to know how many vouchers have been collected at the station, how many vouchers are received at the IPAS and traffic accounts. So we will come to know how many vouchers are not received, and we can monitor it. This entire process is done through an automated reconciliation. If through automated reconciliation, if there is any, if the vouchers are matched, it will go for internal check. If something is not matched, then it will go to IPAS data, check it out manually, verify. Because there may be some data entry errors, there can be some decimal error, something. So all this can be rectified through manual system only. The internal check, basically on every voucher we have to carry out some internal check, because we are supposed to see whether the money collected, money entered is correct or not, whether the voucher is authenticated or not, etc., etc. So that once that internal check is finalized, whatever amount is finalized, that will go for auto bill generation. System will generate a bill against a particular party, and it gives the complete details of bills to be attached with that. Thereby, we are incorporated, and once bill is generated, it will reflect in the accounts office balance sheet. So every month, what is the bills raised, what is the amount realized, and what is the balance outstanding, and the same thing will reflect in the accounts office balance sheet, and the same will be transferred to traffic group part C.
Yeah.
So far, DAMS has taken the consolidated personal revenue data of PRS years and generated a 6-year statement from 2017 onwards. 6-year statement is a statistical statement where different types of class, different classes, passengers of different classes, number of passengers and number of number of passengers and amount and other related details. That is true. Now, apportionment matters for PRSUTs is also being used by all the zonal railways. Catering apportionment matrix for PRS is also online. That is live. So that is also being used. So 6-year statistical statement for PRSUT is also being compiled in the DAMS module. All these things have already been taken care. It is being used by everybody. Now finally DAMS has come in the DAMS portal. 6-year originating basis is done. 6-year carried basis is also done. Developer utility for entering manual data. This one aspect was pending for a long, that is printed car tickets and PPTs, manual PPTs. So printed car tickets, I think many railways have stopped this because board has issued guidelines to issue pre-printed UTS tickets. With that, PCT would have been stopped. And manual PPTs are of course long back it is stopped, but still some special tickets in the manual board is being issued. Special ticket for coach booking, train booking, military trains booking. For this purpose, PPT is still being used in many railways. So, in order to bring that information into account, so we have kept this open for everybody. It is being utilized by all the zonal railways. Please note that this information has to be fed into every month to get the correct revenue status. So, in that 6-year statement, various statements are available. Input status for apportionment, centralized apportionment matrix, 6-year for UTSPRS originating carried, for in a zonal railway as well as IR, entire thing. These all the reports are available in TAMS. Whoever is using TAMS and using 6-year statement, they can very well see the reports. So far we have integrated FOIS for RR information, integration FOIS for taking goods apportionment data, preparation of traffic with Part B and JV generation. This is also done. Recently online JV was generated in the month of May and June by every railway, May by selected railways, it is successfully generated. So traffic book part E, which is takes care of apportionment data that comes from FOIS, has been through TAMS. Integration with PRS UTS for military data is under progress. It is likely to be finished. We are given the target of August 15th. So anyway, that will be done shortly. Computerized balance sheet, it is true. Only for minor, we are waiting for this error sheet module to be finalized and station. All the zonal railways have already been instructed to generate online balance sheet immediately for this particular month onwards, and many have generated because of certain opening errors in the differences in the opening balance, warfare's average. There are many teething problems that are being resolved, once that minor issues are settled, then our balance sheet will be through. So, generation of traffic book part A are through already. Integration with this is done. Integration with PRS UTS files for military paramilitary vouchers data, this is also done. Developer module for sharing information through different zonal TA office users. User management we are planning, it is under process, it is also almost all done. It will be rolled because we are waiting for FOIS and IPAS to integrate with this module. That's for that purpose it is held up. In this user manual, now why this user manual introduced? Because many railways have very short of staff, some railways have a little extra. So to compensate in that, there has to be some flexibility, because I cannot presume based on one railway that the same situation prevails in other railways. It is not possible, it is not practical even. So for that, I have to give a flexibility to the local authorities whereby they will decide to which work to be given to whom. Once that is decided, then work will move smoothly based on the local conditions, their workload, their nature of work, etc. because in certain railways, I came to know in Southwestern Railway, hardly some 7 people are there. In WCR, 4 people are there. So with that, it is very difficult to survive. Ultimately, they have to work. So they have to work, the flexibility has to be given. The manual intervention has to be minimized. So with this module, wherever you want to minimize the work, wherever you want to give more flexibility to distribute the work evenly, this module is required. So that concerned person can look into the activities assigned to him, and the other person can look into with the condition that in case of absence, somebody can take care of. Where sufficient staff are available, it's not a big issue. This is exclusively meant for that purpose. Now, work in progress. So, error sheet module is still in, still not at finalized, but almost all 80% of the work is completed. It is taken in FOIS majority, and the error sheet link is given in the TAMS. Account alert disposal of AD and NAD, this is an extension of error sheet module. This is also almost all done. Once error sheet module is implemented, this process will also be implemented. Integration of IPAS transfer to zonal apportion share through JV. This is in progress. This is in progress because zonal apportionment share, the TC is for collected assets. The TC is extended. A manual JV is to be prepared. So that we are planning to stop. So automated TC, automated JV has to be generated. We are planning for that. Generation of traffic book part C and part D is waiting because accounts office module balance sheet is not finalized, because that is a prerequisite condition for compiling traffic book part C. Integration with IPAS, taking TR node and CR node. This is we are working. I'll just brief about CR node, how it should be generated. See, majority of the station transactions are generated and payment is made through e-payments, especially in goods. Of course, PRS and UDS, now transactions are moving from cash to e-payments, online payments, using UPI, credit card and other modes. So we are planning to capture that information through system, duly giving certain manual inputs for compilation of that TGR. Once the manual data is entered in the utility, automatically CR node will be generated. So manual CR node need not be prepared. A automatic CR number will be generated. A CR node will be generated, and that will be transmitted to IPAS. Once that is transmitted to IPAS, there is no question of physical CR node. Only vouchers CR node. Vouchers has to be submitted to traffic accounts office. Then physically it has to be verified. Compared with the IPAS entry, then only it can be acknowledged. So for CR node for cash, once the CR node is submitted through online and cash is reconciled with the bank statement, then CR node can be acknowledged. There is no question of physical submission of CR node. So we are planning in that way, and similarly TR node also. Once this entire thing is done, this cash and pay module is reflected, the credit portion of the balance sheet is reconciled thoroughly. We are planning, we are regularly in touch with Chris team. We are conducting meetings at the highest level, GM FOIS, GM TAMS and GM RMS and PEDA, sometimes AM budget level. We are discussing a lot of many things. We are streamlining the system, how best it can be utilized, where we are lagging, where the support is required. We are discussing very micro level issues even. Now, traffic book part B has already been implemented. In this traffic book part A, the traffic book part A, what the apportionment says in the apportionment module, that is transferred to traffic book part B, automatic JV is generated, data is transferred to IPAS, then IPAS JV is generated. The JV is directly, authorized JV will be transferred to book section. Please note that there is no question of authorization of the JV generated for traffic book part B. It is authorized JV. Once the data is confirmed, then an automatic JV is to be generated, that will be transferred to book section. So present position matrix comes from this manual exchange of net results, manual feeding of JV in IPAS, that is completely stopped. A new file for net result is generated, exporting data through IPAS. then system basal generation of railway wise outward inward JVs for incorporation in the account current. Now work to be taken in the near future, what we are planning is yet to be taken up is account current. Once traffic book part D is completed, we can go for online account current generation. Goods and coaching balance sheet, internal check and error sheet generation. Internal check, I am talking about internal check. Internal check is not as the part of TAMS so far. So we are planning that also. Input screen for functionalities for different sections of traffic account service. Now traffic accounts functions with the different sections. So everybody has their own role, their own level of internal check, their own activities. Probably in some railways, one person is doing all the activity. In some other railways, it may not be true. So, for every activity to capture their internal check information and carry out the internal check, we are planning to develop one utility screen for each section. So, rising debit and clearance of debits is another activity which we are focusing now, and it will be through very shortly. Now I'll come to how traffic accounts module looks like. So before that, so this is how traffic accounts TAMS module is conceived, developed and implemented, and what we are looking forward for further development on this issue. Let us go to a practical way. Traffic accounts module will look like this. The moment you log in, this is the dashboard, this is the functions available in it. Apportionment, 6-year statical statement, PCD, PPT screen, parcel traffic, balance sheet, AOB, traffic book, TIA, and other things. These are all the functions available traffic records of TAMS module. This is how goods balance sheet will reflect on TAMS. I'll try to open the live one. Let me try it. I hope this is visible to everybody. Hello?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. In the TAMS balance sheet, it will look like that. These are all the various divisions available in the Zonal Railway. Of course, I am showing Central Railway. Let us click on one division. All this balance sheet will be displayed at different stations. If you click this view, it will take to the balance sheet. This is the balance sheet. So, this is the debit side. This is the credit side. If you click on opening balance, it will give the complete details of opening balance. It will give the goods, that is freight, it will give the complete details of freight. Here two columns are available as on date, FOIS amount and item amount. FOIS amount, what we are doing is not now, since it is not completely stabilized, we are entering this item amount. FOIS amount comes from FOIS, item amount comes from manual balance sheet. Once the complete online balance sheet is received, then there will not be this column, only audited amount will come. By default, of course, audited amount will be same FOIS amount. If there is any correction is to be carried out, that can be carried out here in this item amount. So finally, this this amount has to be tallied with this. Balance sheet item, cash, bills, other vouchers, special credit, closing balance, this total has to tally this. So this is how TAM's balance sheet will look like. This is how we are doing the correction in the balances. This screen will be available only for a shorter period. Once online balance sheet is ready, this will not be available. This is the first amount received. This is actual amount ideally through as per the manual balance sheet. So we are making an entry. We are giving the remarks why there is a difference, and finally we are tallying it just because we have to take this to traffic book part A. So we have one mechanism whereby we are monitoring how many balance sheets are received, how many balance sheets are verified, and what is the status of each zonal railway wise. So with this we will come to know, let us say this is for the month of January. Of course, January everything is done. But this is one mechanism whereby we are closely monitoring the progress of balance sheets in the TAMs. Now, traffic book part A. Traffic book part A format will be like this. I'll show you. This is it, traffic book part A goods for the month of January 21. I am just showing for an example only. This is the same old format, we have not changed anything. All these transactions are consolidated. Once consolidated, this will give the division wise totals. Please note this, there is a minus like this. This is nothing but the special credit adjustments in that particular month. I hope you are aware that special credit will be deducted from the originating earnings of that particular month. So once it is deducted, then only you will come to know what is exactly the originating earnings. So finally it is summarized, breakup of total goods earnings, right, excluding GST. Miscellaneous goods excluding GST, sundry excluding GST, total goods excluding GST and total GST. So you will get all this information. Beyond that, some other adjustments are still there. See, now you see the beauty of this. This module, this report is available to everybody in the zonal railway, whomever is having TAMS login ID. So CCM or senior DCM or DRM can straight away look into this for this division. They will simply see that what is their freight earning GST, what is that particular month. Immediately they can access this information, get the data. So this is, it becomes so flexible and easily accessible. This is the data for traffic book part A JV. Once this is confirmed, location, expenditure and amount. Amount is here. That inward and both outward. JV can be generated. See, click to send JV details in IPAS. The moment you click it, the entire thing will go to IPAS where the JV is generated.
Sir, it seems the online one is not activated in the screen.
No, not yet. Not yet. Because it is not completely implemented. You are talking about traffic book part B.
Whatever you said.
No. Not completely. Because unless the module is not ready, I cannot implement online.
You said that online we can see that is the reason.
No. See, once that is implemented, now traffic book part A and traffic book part B are online.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so traffic book part A gives the consolidated picture of revenue. So that is available to everybody. Only thing they have to get the login ID. Okay, okay, balance sheets and other things. Many things are not so far not given. Gradually it will come. That's what my point is. We are keeping the target of August, certain target for August 15. Once that period is reached, then definitely everything will be straight away taken online.
Yeah.
I'll show you. This is AOB, AOB functionality. All the vouchers are, as I explained earlier, all the vouchers from PRS UPS are taken. They have segregated category wise. Once that is segregated, let us take one category. In this this all these voucher details. So in the Bhusawal division, entry details for PRS warrants really as well as parametric and vouchers for the month October 20 from this state to this state. Bhusawal division, booking location, all the locations. Only two vouchers are generated. Now, this information from this column to this column, this entire things come from PRS. Transaction date, booking location, division, from station, to station, class, blah, blah. This entire thing come from PRS.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah, please.
Weight is not moving, maybe. Just you goods balance with data on your slide only is visible.
I could not get you. Once again?
Whatever you are telling regarding Bhusawal division or something is not visible in the screen.
It is there. Division is a VSL.
No. But the participants, it is not visible. That's not there. So that's what they are giving in chart box also. Just you get
the one. Okay.
It will not be moving.
No. You are able to view the screen, na?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes,
so I am selecting the front date. I am selecting today. In the division, I am selecting Bhusawal. Yeah, you want me to select all the divisions of Central Way? This is Central Way login ID. That's why you are able to see only Central Way.
That's what you are telling, but it is not visible. There is a confusion.
Oh. My dear, I am using my login ID.
That's what, sir. But it is able to see in the on screen, no? Telling. So you can see this point, all the things are not.
No. Same screen will be visible to you the moment you enter into DAMS through your login ID.
Yes, sir. What you said is 100% correct, sir. But we are able to see as we are.
Okay. So I'll give the clarification.
Yes.
Friends, please try to understand. I am using my login ID of Central Railway to demonstrate how a TAMS look like. Okay, but ultimately the same features, same columns, same reports, formats are shown to you using your login ID. You can see all these your data related to your railway. Don't get confused. This is Central Railway data. I am selecting Central Railway information. Please try to understand that.
Yes, sir. It is clear.
Okay. Now it is clear, na? Because this is only a demo, yeah. you cannot accept Gorakhpur division information in Central Way. I am selecting Central Way because I am using Central Way login ID. Okay, the moment Central Way login ID is used, definitely it will be filtered. I cannot give all the Pan-Indian railway divisions to everybody. So that has to be filtered. So try to understand, this is only a demo. Okay? In this, if you see this, this information comes from BRS and UPS. Here the voucher amount, you can voucher number, voucher issuing date and voucher type, voucher issuing authority. These fields are editable, because voucher number, there can be a typing error, voucher issuing date can also be, there can be some typing error, voucher type, of course, there are different types, these are all various types available, and by selecting correct one, billing will be done easily. Now, who is issuing authority, whom it should be billed, these two columns will take care of that. Then finally, there is one checkbox. The moment you click it here, that means you have verified everything. See this message. You have verified the transaction, you are accepting it. The moment you press OK, it will go to the bill. So this is internal screen. This serves two purposes. Reconciliation of physical voucher with system data as well as internal checkers. Then once you accept it, you cannot do anything. There is no question of going back.
Sir.
Tell me.
Sir, it shows that the website is module.
Which one?
Shows this is a present PPT and it shows module, sir.
PPT? Okay. Tell me, which one? Tell me, sir.
Sir, please click the share screen and end the present share screen and add new ones.
No, you are talking about PPT only, na?
Sir, I am sure that Kushal module, login ID or login ID, tabs.
I am not able to get your point. You want to see the PPT, you are referring PPT?
The PPT is going on, sir. But if you want, you can replace PPT by showing
that. Okay, I got it.
Yes.
I'm sorry, I'm not that tech savvy. I'm trying to learn now itself. Anyway,
click the share screen, that's all.
Fine.
Click share screen. Will end the present presentation and you can add a new one. It's up to you, sir.
Okay.
Yeah, it is visible, sir, now.
Okay. Now, this is how TAMS look like. Now, let us go to TIA module, because the TIA module is a little unique and the functionalities are different completely. Yeah, this is TIA district management. So in this, probably whoever is there from the TIA cadre, they will better appreciate this functionality. Others may not be conversant with this system. District number 123410 and district name, active from and to. Try to understand this active from and to, because district can be active for a particular period, generally, because of the constraint in TIA category, many districts are merged and many districts are even one division district is attached with another division, something like that. that flexible mode is being operated in all the railways. So to accommodate that, we are giving, and to store the past history also, we have created this function, active from 1 to. Say today I have created one CSTM, one booking mistake for this period. So tomorrow, let us say after 3 months, I want to close this CSTM booking and want to make CSTM booking, parcel, luggage, BCTA, entirely one district. So I'll give a different name, headquarter TA, headquarter CSTM, something like that. Then I have to change this active. Once I change this, normally old data will be erased. So to avoid that, if I want to see what was there in some 3 years back, I will not get. So to avoid that, I am giving this, thereby I am preserving the old history also. I am continuing with the present changes also. So this is the district management. So every district is defined very clearly. And then station management. This station management, you have to clearly define the stations, their periodicity, number of inspections and class. So valid from 1 to, and the station to which district the station is attached. These are all the station management. So all the stations are to be mapped with a certain district. No station can be kept isolated. EIA management. TIA district. So every district has to be assigned to one TIA. It can be a headquarter TIA, it can be district TIA, it can be LR TIA, whatever nomenclature you are using in your corresponding zone. Staff number, employee name, TIA type, district, and post from this period to this period. So there is a flexibility to edit this when somebody is transferred, somebody is retired, all such situation, we can edit it, we can attach to somebody else. So inspection station, we have these many reports. Reports on inspection schedule, inspections open during the month, inspections on hand, inspections overdue. See, TIA cadre, there is a peculiar feature. The correspondence or monthly performance information is received only at the end of the month. That is first week, generally first week of next month. Till that time, headquarter will not know where TIA is working, what he is doing, how many inspections he has carried out, completed, or on hand or in progress. That information comes to headquarter only after completion of the month. Till that time, completely everybody in headquarter will be in dark. So we have created this information, this report, which is very dynamic. Dynamic means the moment, I forgot to show this. Forecast and moment. See, this is the forecast. TA has to give the forecast of next 10 days and he has to give the district station where he is going and what activity he is going to complete there and some remarks. See, he can book a day under this inspection, office day, business day, special duty, special check, leave and other. They are all clearly available in the list. So he has to specify a day where he is working, how he is availing that day and with the remark. So this is a forecast. Once forecast is done, then he will save it. Once that is saved, then he will go to movement. So in the moment, you will come to know what is the forecast and you will come to know what you are going to do on that particular day. So for this period, he has done the forecast like this. Then the moment you start filling the movement details, the corresponding has to be ideally it should be the same because you have forecasted this. But there is a flexibility to enter a different thing and you have to give a remark. Reason for change. Once a inspection is opened, automatically IR number is generated. You need not give any number on your own. This is a standardized number for Indian Railways. So that number is generated. So once that number is generated, the data is transferred in this table. The moment days are booked, the time scale, cumulative number of days booked is displayed here. At the same time, if you want to close the inspection for any reason, because no much traffic or you have put extra effort, you want to close it, then you can close the inspection. The moment you close the inspection, then only you can enter the reporting data. Till that time, it will not reflect in the reporting system. So this is forecast and movement. So this inspection station, I'll select one. Data is not available. So this information give how many inspections are, this is a division wise. You can select any of the division. You will come to know which division is lagging behind, you will come to know which division is progressing, and you will come to know which district is lagging behind. You want to see the progress of concerned division, you can see. Of course, in this data is not available, that's why I am not able to display the data. But the format will be like this: inspection due, inspection open during the month, inspections on hand, and overdue. So this completely gives the information of inspection process. Now let us come to reports. This is the screen for headquarter influence section. Anyway, this screen will not be given to DIA. This is only for headquarter inspection section. Headquarter inspection section can verify all these DIA reports. I'll show you one by one. And he will see the IR number. Once this is admitted, then a registration number will be generated. Let us go to the reports. The report will be look like, this is TA1F, all the TAs may be aware of TA1F, 2F, 4F, 6F, 7F, etc. So this is the same format given in TIA manual, nothing new. The entire thing is available here. This checklist is same replica of TIA manual. Everything has to be entered. Once everything is entered, here, the moment you say edit, you can type here. Everything can be typed. The moment you submit, it will be submitted. Before submitting, you have to check once again if whether every data you have entered is correct or not. So we are planning for a digital signature to all the TIAs. Then it will be very easy for everybody to sign the document. So far, we have not implemented that. I want to show this TA6F because TA6F we have a peculiar feature. We have introduced a new feature in TA6F. TS except probably other traffic account people may not be aware of this functionality. TS except is the observations of irregularities recorded by TIA and remarks of commercial staff at the station. The same, both the remarks will go to senior DCM office. They have to give their reply. Finally, accounts office will take a decision on the action taken by commercial department and the irregularity. So, what we are planning is, since commercial this login ID cannot be given to commercial department, we are planning to upload the TS6F in a manual mode through a PDF format, and then one facility will be given. One facility will be given through this. Normally, the remarks can be recorded here, but he has to upload a TS6F form in a scanned format here, so that it will become a documentary evidence for the remarks given there. One more feature we are planning is this amount of loss. This amount of loss, of course, TA also raises the debit as well, similarly to traffic accounts office. For raising a debit, we are developing one more error sheet model exclusively for TIAs and allowing credit also for the TIAs. That this column takes care of that. The moment amount of loss is mentioned here, then the system will ask to raise a debit. So then a screen will come up. Now it is not completely ready. The screen will come up where TIA has to completely fill up the details. Then once it is submitted, automatically it will go to balance sheet. It will go to station. Then the station will accept it or reject it. Then only it will go to balance sheet. But the entire process has to be taken before generation of the next balance sheet. That is prerequisite condition. So normally TS6F doesn't have this amount of loss. Now we have created this so that this same amount will be taken in the balance sheet as a debit. And this entire report will come as a comprehensive error report. And duly submitting this TSX of the remark of station staff. All these reports, these are all standard reports. Standard reports format and process mentioned in the TA manual is replicated here. Nothing new. We have not created anything new. Only this internal check portion is created. Internal check portion, the moment the headquarter receives the report, the headquarter TIA will verify it, whether it is in concern with the procedure available in TIA module or not. Any irregularities are there. Then he will put up the report to higher authority, either for closure or taking for further correspondence with commercial department. So the commercial department remarks continues, and once the final remarks are come, he will enter the remark and put up for the closure of the report. So he will give the remark, date and remark. This date and remark will continue till finalization is done. Once it is approved, report will be closed. Or it will be, if there is a lacuna, then it will be reverted to the headquarter TIA. So headquarter TIA, as per the instructions of higher authority, he has to act about it. So this is the TIA module. I hope I have cleared everything. Okay. This is my presentation. Basically, this is an overview. I cannot say I have explained everything from the beginning to last. But once you start working on TAMS, you will come to know how beautiful it is designed, how flexible it is, how useful it is over and above. If you have any doubts and other things, let us have a discussion.
Yes, participants, please you can unmute yourself and ask any question. Yes, sir.
My request to everybody is one by one. Let us have that one by one. Because, one question, one answer is the ideal situation. Anybody can ask, no issue, but one by one. Mr. Raghunath.
Sir, I am Raghunath, TA Secunderabad, sir. South Central Railway. So my doubt is, rising debits through 6-7. Is it dealt by TIS itself or topic I could solve the other sheet?
No, TIS itself. There will be an exclusive module for TIS. In the error sheet module itself, it's a part of error sheet module. It is under progress. Once that is done, exclusive functionality will be given to TIS. They can raise the debit. We are linking that with the TIS itself. That is the only thing.
Okay.
So that will be allowing credit also through TIS error sheet module. Traffic accounts has no role. They play their own role.
Okay, sir. Is there any planning to provide laptops and these things?
That is a policy, Maria. It is
okay, sir.
Sir, I want to know.
So please.
Sir, I want to know what will be the advantage for implementation of TAMS?
Implementation of TAMS, in the first two slides, I explained the same thing. Advantage is, you will get, there are two levels. One is highest management level, second is operational level. Highest management level, everybody will get the data instantly without depending on traffic accounts office. ERM sitting at Nagpur, or CCM sitting at the headquarter, or GM sitting at the GM office, they will come to know what is the revenue position immediately. They did not ask anybody, and somebody did not compile everything and give it to GM after 5 days. Instantly it is available, number one. Lower level operation, manual intervention is minimal. Once the manual intervention is minimal, then it will be, errors will be minimized at the barest minimum. So that also we are trying to further minimize, but it is difficult. Somebody has to enter some data, it is expected. So at barest bare minimum level of errors, we are working with this model. So that is the advantage. Day by day, staff are being reduced in the sense, retired, no replacement. So in that scenario, we have to rely on system, we have to work with system, whereby we should also get benefited, and the system is also available to everybody. That is our concept.
Okay, sir.
This is Kamishwar from NC Railway.
Please.
How can do bifurcation of current and previous outstanding, because there are no provision in TAMS for this?
Bifurcation of?
Outstanding in current and previous. Like damaged and what is?
Achcha. Damaged garment is bifurcation is already there.
No sir, there is a damaged garment. But the previous and current outstanding bifurcation, there is no provision in TAMS. Actually, we are intending outstanding current and previous.
Current and previous, okay, I got. No. There is opening balance.
Yes, sir.
There is an opening balance. Opening
yes,
balance will take care of previous outstanding.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Current month, it is coming from twice.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So if there is some clearance from opening balance or as well as current balance, that will come through cash or payable?
Yes, sir.
Once that is over, then standard practice is that remaining will be in the closing balance?
Yes, sir.
Now the problem is, you don't have the opening balance and their history in the TAMS.
Yes.
Okay. So till that entire amount is absorbed, you have to maintain manual details. We are literally fighting with the Christian Railway Board to give a specific feature in the FOIS to incorporate the history of the complete opening balances and error sheets. Even that is not there in error sheets. Tomorrow if you ask me, sir, previous error sheet ka kya karna hai, mere paas koi jawab nahi hai. But we are fighting for that, and that will be done. Because without history, we cannot survive. We cannot complete that. Tomorrow, let us say damage is 1 lakh. Somebody asks you what is the breakup of who is the party who has not paid 1 lakh. You will not know, you cannot tell. That information has to be captured some way or other. That is more important. We are struggling to get it. It will come, I am sure.
Okay, sir, thank you.
Anybody?
Sir, excuse me. In the balance sheet you have shown, debit side, first side is local goods. And the last item is outward paid goods. What is the difference? Why it shown separately? First item.
No. You are looking at opening balance. That local goods is opening balance. You can check it
that
out.
That is opening balance.
That is opening balance.
Okay. It's not shown as opening balance.
No. I click the opening balance. That breakup is shown.
What about foreign? It's shown as goods local.
Opening, you are talking about opening balance.
No, it's shown as goods local.
No.
First item.
I have shown one example of bulk cement corporation siding balance sheet.
Okay.
In that, foreign paid may not be there, Baba. This is only a demo. I have shown one example. The transaction need not be there.
Okay.
But
okay, sir.
What my point ultimately is, if you click the opening balance, you will get the complete information of the opening balance of breakup.
Okay.
Okay, like that.
Okay, sir, thank you.
Okay.
I have one question to ask, sir.
Please.
With the outsourcing of PRS and UPS tickets, this to NRH and to JTBS and all that, sir.
Yes.
I'm talking about tickets which are across the counter, issued across the counter, sir.
Okay.
And then with the reduction of staff, and then again with the increase in number of train services. So how are we going? And then again the introduction of TAMS. How are we able to tap the errors that would
subsequently. See, finally everything has to be accommodated in the station balance sheet. There is no other option. There is no shortcut for us. Okay? Whatever is available in the station balance sheet, that will reflect in the TAMS. Number two. Now come to the number three. Now only major issue is we are going to get single balance sheet for coaching transactions, including YTSK, JTPS, post office, other outside parties, parcels, everything. Once single balance sheet comes, you have to struggle to understand the balance sheet in the manual system otherwise. Now system takes care of it. You can see the complete data, you can see the totals, you can verify the information directly, and you can accept it. Even if 100 trains are run, it makes no difference. 10 years back, how many trains were there, and now how many trains are? Forget about COVID pandemic. 1 year back, how many trains were running, and 10 years back, how many trains were running? There is a lot of new trains are introduced. Those many JTPS, YTSK centers are opened, outside outsourced counters are opened, but still we are working. We are working with the reduced strength because we have simplified the process through different computerization. Earlier it was office, now this is TAMS. TAMS is more flexible, more accommodative, more informative, more integrated. That is why it will become much easier for you to work. For that purpose only this thing has been taken up. With the reducing staff capacity, even the number of trains are increased, ultimately you are going to get one single figure of passenger revenue under PRS and UTS, irrespective of the number of trains and stations. That's it. Anyway, only your responsibility will definitely go up because you have to be more careful, more alert on the figures which you are accepting. That is the only crucial issue. Okay. Anybody, anything? Finally, my request to everybody is, I have given an overall picture, try to understand that. And I have given a demo of TAMS. The moment you get the login ID or whoever is having the login ID, they can happily view the details available with them. They can experiment, don't try to enter any abnormal data, but they can browse the fields and various streams available in the dams, they can very well see that. They try to familiarize with them and try to understand how the system is developed, how to get the best out of it. Then only you will enjoy the dams. Otherwise, you will definitely find this is a very tough job.
Good afternoon, sir.
Yeah, good afternoon. Tell me.
Sir, present nodal agency of the dams. Which railway, sir?
Central railway.
Central railway.
Yes.
Okay, thanks.
Participants, anybody can still, if you have any query, you can ask. Sir is very happy to clarify. Otherwise, we will close the session. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you for your patience extending your knowledge to all our participants. Thank you, one and all. And as usual, tomorrow's session will be login time at 11 o'clock. And session will commence from 11:30 hours. And tomorrow session is on GEM, Government E-Marketplace, by Sri Ankur Srivastava, Deputy CEO of Stores of South Central Railway. Okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay, sir. Thanks, everybody.
Thank you, sir.
Shall I take leave, sir?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Please.
Okay.
One second.
कल का पेमेंट करना हुआ है लास्ट कल हाजीपुर वाला दिया है नया वाला लिस्ट जो दिया है एडिशनल वाला